In a previous post, I gave you my recommendations of manipulatives that I love. Well, in today's video, I'm going to give you some rules when you are using manipulatives in your classroom. I'm Christina Tondevold, the Recovering Traditionalist, and today I'm going to give you 3 rules for how to use math manipulatives in the elementary classroom. In our quest to build our math minds so we can build the math minds of our students. Okay, so rule number 1 is tied to the video I did before when I talked about my favorite math manipulatives, which is just let the kids play. So rule number 1, let the kids play. I'm not going to go too much in detail with this. I will link to the post below this video that talks more about that. But the general idea is that kids cannot develop an understanding of a manipulative and the connections that that manipulative can build for them if we try to directly teach them how to use the manipulative. They need to play and explore that manipulative and start to make connections on their own, and we can help make those connections, but it doesn't come from directly teaching kids step by step how to use a manipulative. Rule number 2, always have manipulatives available. Typically, we just bring out the manipulatives when the lesson calls for it. So these are like special occasions, right, for the kids. And it's no wonder that we end up getting kids who will build swords out of Unifix cubes. They're just not used to having the manipulatives as mathematical tools. If we have them out available all the time, kids start to understand these are mathematical tools. They are not toys that we only bring out and use on special occasions. There are lots of examples that you can find, especially out there on Pinterest and Instagram, of teachers who have created like a mathematical manipulative bar, basically, where they have it all laid out all the time and kids can come over and grab any manipulative they want. Or you'll see ones where they just have manipulative tubs that are on the tables, right? If you're in groups, in the center of those groups are the manipulatives. They're always available so that if kids need them and want to use them to help them solve a problem, they can. We as the teacher are not dictating, here is the time to use the manipulative and here's the time when we don't. It's just, if you need them, let's use them. Okay, now rule number 3, don't use manipulatives in isolation. So when we tend to do like a lesson and it says to use a manipulative, we tend to just use the manipulative and not connect it to those other parts of the CRA model. Now, if you're not familiar with CRA, I did another video all about that, which I will link below this, but the C stands for concrete, and that's typically the manipulatives. R stands for representation, which is often a model or a drawing, and A is abstract, which is just the symbols. Our textbooks typically will have a lesson that is concrete, so it uses manipulatives. Instead, my advice is that we should be doing all 3 together as much as we can, and if the kids need it. Like, we're doing a problem, and if some kids need the concrete, they have access to those manipulatives, if you're following rule number 2. If kids don't and they just want to draw, then they can draw. If they have moved past both of those and they're in the abstract world, then they're doing the abstract. But don't just do one of those. It's helpful for kids to be able to see all 3 and make connections. If the lesson says we're doing the concrete, it's fine. Have kids model it, but be drawing a representation. Attach the abstract symbols to it as well, because you've got kids at all different levels. And we talk so much about kids, we need to differentiate for all of our different learners. Yet our lessons don't often do that because we aren't allowing kids to work in wherever they are in that CRA fashion. the more that we can connect the concrete manipulatives to representations and abstract symbols, the more connections they are going to build around all three of those, the manipulatives, the drawings and models, and the symbols. So when you are using manipulatives, don't just use them in isolation. If your kids are using it, have them draw models, or you do the model, the representation, and attach the symbols to it. It depends upon where your kids are at, what grade levels they are, and so on. But kids at all levels need to have access to manipulatives at all times. They need to play and explore, and they need to be able to see the connection of those concrete manipulatives to the models and representations and the abstract symbols. All right, I hope that this has helped you build your math mind so you can go build the math minds of those students. Have a great day.